Hey, what's up everyone? Welcome to my YouTube channel, Life Science with KMD. Today I'm going to explain about importance of gene manipulation in future perspectives. Gene chip. These are medical sensors about the size of a matchbox and feature a tiny DNA microarray. Every square on this grid contains a particular DNA snipped. When a sample of patient DNA comes in contact with this gene chip, this causes some of its square to illuminate, so revealing the level of activation of particular gene. Use in diagnosis. Different types of cancers have been classified on the basis of organ in which the tumor develop. Now, with the evolution of microarray technology, it will be possible for researcher to further classify the type of cancer on the basis of the pattern of gene activated in the tumor cells. Example is characterization of acute lymphoblastic leukemia, also a breast cancer, used in progenies. Example is assessing the likelihood of metastasis in medulloblastoma, that is brain tumor in children. Use in toxicological research. Microarray technology provide a robust platform for the research of impact of toxins on the cells and their passing on to the progeny. Toxicogenomics establish correlation between responses to toxicant and the change in genetic profile of cells exposed to such toxicant. The microarray permit researcher to examine thousands of different genes in the same experiment and thus to obtain a good understanding of the relative level of expression between different genes in an organism. Use in selection of drug. By examining the gene chip under microscope, a patient's genetic suitability for certain drug can therefore be assessed. Experimental gene chip are already available from the supplier for trial. Genetic engineering alters mosquito's sense of smell. In one of the first successful attempts at genetically engineering mosquito, research have altered the way the insect responds to odor. Scientists announced the completion of full genome sequence of the mosquito that transmit dengue and yellow fever. They have altered the sense of smell of mosquito for humans and the insect repellent. The zinc finger nuclease are used specifically to mutant the oncogene of Aedes aegypti. They injected the target zinc finger nuclease into the mosquito embryo, waited for them to mature, identified mutant individual and generated mutant strains that allow them to study the role of orco in mosquito biology. The engineered mosquito showed diminished activity of neurons linked to odor sensing. Then behavioral test revealed. Next is designer babies. The coracular term designer baby refer to the baby whose genetic makeup has been artificially selected by genetic engineering combined with in vitro fertilization to ensure the presence or absence of particular gene or characteristic. In simple term, using biotechnology to choose what type of baby you want, latest research research are in trend. The designer baby is reality now, using technology developed originally for use in animal. What trait could be changed in the designer baby? Gender, appearance, intelligence, disease and personality. Trait selection. Embryo screening involved a process called pre-implantation genetic diagnosis. Embryos are created by in vitro fertilization and grown to 8-celled stage, at which point one or two cells are removed. Scientists then examine DNA of this cell for defects and only normal embryos are replaced in the womb. Three parent babies are human offsprings with three genetic parents created through specialized form of in vitro fertilization, in which the future baby's mitochondrial DNA comes from third party. The procedure is intended to prevent mitochondrial disease, including muscular dystrophy, heart, liver condition. It is subjected to considerable controversy in the field of bioethics. Pros and cons. Reduce risk of genetic diseases. Reduce risk of inherited medical condition. Keep pace with other doing it. Better chance the child will succeed in life. Increased lifespan can give child gene that parent do not carry. Prevent next generation of family from getting characteristic disease. Now, what are the cons? Only the rich can afford it. Could create a gap in society. Loss of individuality. Baby has no choice in the matter. Gene often have more than one use. Other children in family could be affected by parents' decision. Xenograft. Transgenic pigs. If we could eliminate the pig protein that human don't reintroduce necessary human protein in pig via genetic engineering, then the chance of rejection could be minimized. The creation of such genetic modified pig could solve the problem of organ availability. In 2002, scientists reported the generation of cloned genetically modified pig lack a sugar molecule that normally stimulate a strong immune response. Since then, pig containing many human genes that can help the pig immune cell interact successfully with human immune cells have been generated, and their organ have been tested in pig non-human primate transplant models. The use of this modified and transgenic pig as an organ can help prevent the recipient immune system from immediate rejection. The transplantation of heart and kidney from these transgenic plant has greatly improved the survival of xenograft in non-human primates. Today, a pig kidney may last for a month and can survive for multiple years. However, the primate are still depend on immunosuppressive medication to control the immune rejection. Xenograft in another exciting strategy in xenotransplantation is the tolerance approach, which tricks the recipient immune system to recognize the pig molecule as safe as administering pig bone marrow cells to the recipient prior to organ transplantation. Donor bone marrow contain progenitor immune cells that can subsequently develop into mature immune cells in the recipient body. These donor immune cells in the recipient will not attack transplanted organ because they recognize itself. This method was first used successfully in human-to-human transplantation clinically. Patient who received donor bone marrow with a kidney transplantation become tolerant, meaning that no immune suppression drug were required for transplanted kidney to function even 1 year after the kidney transplantation. Scientists are currently studying the tolerance in a well-established pig to non-human primate xenotransplantation model.
Thanks for watching my video. Please subscribe to my channel by clicking on subscription button. Subscription doesn't cost you any money. To get a notification, click on a bell icon. Do like and share this video with friends and family. If you have any kind of feedback, do share it on a comment box. Thank you.